And speaking of trends, what do you have to say about them?
I think trends, all trends, start from the street up.
Yeah.
You know, any trend that's happening, like I'll say in the last 4 or 5 years, yeah, is actually something that starts off being very affordable.
Yeah.
It's something that a Jessica Alba will see someone at their concert wearing, you know.
Right.
It's the top guys seeing what people on the street are wearing, you know. So every single trend out there,
yeah,
you know, unless you're walking into a Gucci store, comes from people on the ground, you know. And so that's why vintage is coming back, because like Macklemore's new song, Thrift Shop, that's where you go shopping, you know,
yes,
for that classic stuff.
Yeah.
You know, that goes for $20, but you're going to find that same stuff in a Gucci store.
Yeah, going for thousands of dollars.
Yeah, for thousands. So just know that every trend that starts from the street.
Now, away from that, we have style icons, people who dress up, and each time you see them, they're looking neat, they're looking slick.
Kanye dresses to impress all the time.
And he gets it.
And he gets it right, yeah. Well, apart from when he throws on like a Michael Jackson glove. But, you know, yeah. International ladies, Jessica Alba, she gets it right as well.
And locally, which guy dresses?
A guy.
Yeah.
One Navio. And out of the girls, I don't know. Who's always look? Zari looks pretty good. She knows
Zari.
What to, you know what I mean?
Yeah, Zari does pretty good. You need to see my co-host Moshe, the pieces he puts together.
Yeah?
You'll be blown away.
Yeah?
Trust me.
Okay.
Your favorite
some competition,
model.
Moshe versus Navio next week on Fashionista.
Yes.
Don't miss the challenge. The showdown is happening right here.
All right, now tell us about your look today.
Oh, no, not today.
Yes, today.
Today I'm head honchoed up.
Uh-huh.
Got the head honcho, the hat, the shirt, you know, have to protect myself, so I got Jesus.
From all evil.
Yes, all the evil. I've got the tag her on the wrist. Jeans Obahu, got the classic Adidas with the tongue sticking out.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I'm keeping it very...
And the shades, you didn't tell us about the shades.
Yeah, Ray-Ban.
Are those authentic?
Unfortunately, yeah. But I'm going to stop buying authentic.
It's always good having you here. And so say happy Easter to all your fans out there and let them know what's up.
So big up, guys. Happy Easter. I hope you guys have a really good one. Check out my new song. That's a new Easter track. Leka Kwenye Mujiza are coming out soon. There's going to be a lot of fashion forward stuff happening in the video. I take it authentic. I take it to the tuxedo. I take it everywhere. So please make sure you check out the new video, Leka Kwenye Mujiza, and keep it locked right here with your girl Tattoo. Peace.
Well, turns out that very soon we won't have agriculture as a backbone, considering how very many talented people out there. And actually, speaking of celebrities, we have one stylist and makeup artist I happened to run into during the street style. Now, if you don't know what street style is, while I'm moving along the street or Moshe is moving, we bump into someone who is exceptionally dressed. Could be something casual, could be something, you know, unique, but you are setting the trend while moving along the street, and we don't hesitate. We stop you there and then. Have a little chat about what you're dressed like. You tell us where you're going, why you're dressed like that, and so much more to give you, you know, more insight on what street style is. Here is something, do take a look. So of course, just like each and every other episode, we do go around the streets to look for those people who are strikingly dressed, you know, the people who are dressed not like your average Ugandan. And if I bump into one, we'll definitely have to talk about his style. Sebo, how are you, Medi?
Oh, hi, how are you? I know, how are you?
I love your outfit.
Oh, really? Thanks.
Tell me about it.
Nothing much. I'm just wearing little skinny jeans.
Nothing much?
Yeah.
Really? Medi, this is nothing much?
Yeah.
Okay, tell me about the jeans.
No, I'm just wearing a little bit skinny jeans.
Okay.
Because it's quite hot and everything, so I want to do something baggy.
Yes, I
pink
guess.
T-shirt, because uh-huh. I'm dark and brings me out.
Yes.
Probably desert sandals, because it's pretty, pretty hot. It's been really, really hot of late.
Yes. All right, so how do we get this look? If I want to get this kind of jeans, T-shirt, how do I get it? Where do I have to shop?
You don't really have to shop anywhere. You just have to have an eye for something really, really nice.
Okay.
That's it, yeah.
All right, so what prompted you to get this look together?
Probably it's because I've been too formal for the past 3 days. I just want to like let it down and everything. I'm giving it to meeting my clients.
Yeah.
So I just want like to have something really, really light.
And what's with the bag? I love anything denim. I'm loving
it. Alright, is it?
Yes.
Everything of mine. You're like 2013, you have to groom yourself.
Of course.
Stylish guy,
yes.
Lots of stuff in there. I have my powder. Oh, did I say that?
You don't have powder all the damn
time. I know.
Time.
Yeah.
Okay, basically the heat has everything to do with it.
Exactly, the heat has everything, probably in summer, Uganda, Kampala.
I love the Ray-Bans. Are those real?
Yeah, honey, the real Ray-Bans.
Are you serious?
Yes, they are.
Okay, so if I have this kind of look, where do I go to if I'm dressed like this?
Probably can go out to lunch.
Okay.
Because you're not quite like a little bit too much dressed or anything.
Yeah.
You just dress for the day and that's it. You can go anywhere though. If you want to go out later tonight, you can just put on a blazer or something.
Oh, amazing. Mm. So how often do you dress like this?
Probably like twice a week.
Twice
like
a week.
Wednesday, Thursday and Friday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Saturday, Sunday, how do you dress? Maybe you're clean?
Yeah. I really, really dress down, but like a little bit more sexy.
Oh, okay. Yeah. The little shorts and a vest and a blazer.
No, like I turned on the little shorts. I turned them down.
Oh.
I turned them down.
You turned them down. Oh, okay.
Sure.
Now, I want to know, where did you shop to come up with this look? Where did you shop?
This is Mr. Price, South Africa.
Okay.
This is Zerman, London.
Yes.
Mr. Price, South Africa. Yeah.
Nice. So,
and the bag is Levi.
And the bag is Levi. Mm. I do love anything Levi.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for your time and thank you for looking this effortlessly amazing.
Thank you,
my
darling.
We'll let you go on with your work.
Like
a dress. Let me go get myself
right.
Something to drink.
See you,
too.
Darling.
Take care. All right. Now, normally, I don't, you know, get on the same side with the guys, but I'm sure they're going to agree with me this time. Have you noticed that some football matches have, you know, more viewership of the ladies than some others? Like, let's see what, not Arsenal, like Liverpool. Very few ladies would go out to watch a game of Liverpool and another game. Probably Blackburn, Southampton. People don't care about that stuff. Real Madrid, on the other hand, we have lots of ladies watching that game, and I'm actually thinking it's probably because of Cristiano Ronaldo. I would watch a Real Madrid game any given day. I'm not saying it's because of Cristiano Ronaldo, it's because I love the team, but yes, the guy looks stunning in almost everything. Get him on the pitch in his jersey, he looks very good. Get him at one of those after parties, he's probably wearing a trench coat, probably a business suit, a t-shirt and jeans. Cristiano Ronaldo looks stunning, and because of that, today he's our eye candy. I love this guy for one thing. I have seen him looking quite, you know, sleek in a suit. Sleek in a t-shirt and jeans, sleek on the pitch after 90 minutes of running back and forth. The guy looks good all the time. Have you seen his hair? Have you seen the shoes he wears? Oh yeah, let's not talk about his cars. Honestly, you have to have a lot of style to drive those cars. So yes, gentlemen, would very, very much highly appreciate if our Uganda Cranes guys started dressing up like that. Maybe we'd show up more. Mwaba SCVida, Simanya Express, Simanya KCCA, Mwambaleko Wemuti. We shall come and watch those games. That's our eye candy this week. In with the new and out with the old. What's hot and what's not is all going to be shown on this week's Trend Alert. Now, very many of you do not know what determines our Trend Alert sometimes. Many a time it will be because of the weather. When it's hot, we'll tell you rock these colors, wear this kind of fabric. And when it's cold, things change up a little bit. Now, the fact that the weather is getting a little bit ugly, we don't want it to be shown and to be seen or reflected in the way you dress. The fact that the weather is gray does not mean you should look all dull and stuff. No. You can lighten up your outfit. First of all, we're going to talk sweater dresses and of course the shirts for the ladies. They look so amazing these days, but if you get one that's really, really short, yes, help us. Do us a favor. Tukusabiye, tuyambi, tuyambi. And you know, incorporate tights. You look very, very amazing. For the guys who don't want their blazers to look all bad and stuff like that, but you feel very cold, the blazer is not enough, get yourself a nice, sleek sweater vest. Normally we would prefer if your blazer has a very, very dull color, probably black or gray, get a colorful sweater vest and incorporate it with your look. For you ladies who go out in those little dresses and they'd want to put on a sweater, no, thank you. We appreciate the fact that you took time to get that beautiful dress, but no, we're not loving the sweater. So what you do is ditch your sweater, get yourself a nice, decent trench coat that can probably go well with your dress. And trust me, you might actually not have to put off the trench coat. You look very amazing. This goes for the guys too. If you're going to hit the bar, what, and you don't want to look all shabby, get your very neat jeans, your nice loafers, and then get yourself a trench coat. You look very amazing. This go well, very, very well with a nice, decent scarf. How you note it, however, is very important. So get that look for this week. That's our Trend Alert. Now, a day has 24 hours, but you'd be surprised what can happen in 24 hours. Lots of things change on various blogs, various websites, and of course, a couple of fashion houses do things here and there. So we get all this stuff and wrap it up for you. Here's this week's fashion news.
Diana's dresses fetch over £800,000. 10 dresses belonging to the late Diana, Princess of Wales, fetched over £800,000 at a Kerry Taylor auction in London last week. Top lot at £240,000 was a midnight blue velvet gown that the royal wore to a state dinner at the White House, at which she danced with John Travolta. It was bought by a British man who wanted to cheer up his wife. Bidders were able to buy a unique slice of British history. We attracted bidders from across the world, including Asia, America, Austria, Australia, and of course the UK, including three important museums. So we are hopeful that now people will actually get to see some of the dresses that belong to the People's Princess, said auctioneer Kerry Taylor. Mila Kunis on endorsing brands she believes in. Mila Kunis only ever wants to work with brands and companies that she truly believes in. The actress, who is the new face of ethical colored gemstone specialist Gemfields, says that endorsing a product that you don't believe in is the hardest job in the world. The 29-year-old was announced as the jewelry company's spokesperson earlier this year after she was approached by CEO Ian Herbotto. Despite not looking to endorse anything at the time, the actress agreed to commit after falling in love with the people that worked at the family-run company. CFD Awards 2013 nominations announced. Alexander Wang and Proenza Schooler lead the CFDA Awards nomination list for 2013 with two nods each. Both have been shortlisted for Women's Wear Designer of the Year and Accessories Design of the Year, first in competition from Marc Jacobs in the former category and Philip Lim in the latter. Tom Brown faces Michael Bastien and Dukie Brown in the menswear category, while Vera Wang has been honored with the Lifetime Achievement Prize. This year's prestigious Founders Award will go to Oscar De La Renta. In other categories, the Board of Directors tribute goes to Colin Atwood, responsible for the costumes of Snow White and the Huntsman and Alice in Wonderland. While this year's Media Prize goes to Tim Blanks of Style.com. The awards will be handed out during a ceremony on June 3rd. Michelle Obama's Vogue cover is finally here. First Lady Michelle Obama is on the cover of the fashion glossy April issue of Vogue magazine. While other presidential first ladies are largely forgotten, Michelle Obama's Let's Move fitness campaign may be her official cause as first lady, but it will not be her greatest legacy. According to Vogue magazine, Michelle's greatest legacy will be permanently redefining the American ideal for femininity, beauty, and womanhood, and her appearances in the magazine will be remembered as such. However, Michelle Obama is not the first lady to grace the cover of Vogue. That honor goes to Hillary Clinton in 1998. Michelle is not the first American African woman to appear on the cover either. The first lady seems to have settled comfortably into her pop culture status as a fashion icon. Years from now, few will remember what President Obama said in his most recent State of the Union address, but some little girl will come across a copy of Michelle Obama's Vogue magazine covers, presenting her in all of her dark brown skin, full lip glory, and see herself and know that she's as beautiful as an American first lady. Almost as important, some people who don't look like that little girl will have learned to appreciate her brown beauty too, thanks to the first lady of style, Michelle Obama.
Quite interesting what has been happening in our fashion world, at least according to the news we have. That brings us to almost the end of the show, but of course I can't leave without giving you a style note. And this week's style note comes from a gentleman known as Herbert Harold Vreeland. He says, clothes cannot make a man, but they've gotten him a good job many a time. So what does he mean by this? It's very important how you dress. Like I earlier said, people address you the way you dress. So if you want to get a job as a lawyer, please keep your shirt. shorts. I know they're cool. Sometimes they're trending. Your nice t-shirt, leave it at home, my friend. Actually, forget you own it. Get yourself a nice suit. Look presentable for that. Go get yourself the job. If you want to go and probably present yourself as a nursery teacher, honestly, I can't go to a school and take my child there when the teacher is rocking shorts and she has a vest, no matter what, because, you know, she's teaching young children. No. So it's very important how you present yourself when you go for a job interview. Like the guy said, clothes can't make a man, but they've gotten him a good job many a time. How about you let me know what you think about the show? Hit me up Facebook, The Urban Fashionista is the page. Like it, recommend it to your friends, leave your posts, your comments. And actually, you can get us in our message inbox. If you have anything quite private you'd like to ask, we'll definitely get back to you. The SMS line, you only get to your phone, type Fashionista, your message, your view, your comment, and send it to 8338. And then we're also on Twitter. Yeah, the fact that Moshe is not around today does not mean he's not around. If you have a question for him, hit him up on Twitter at Moshology, and I'm there at Tattoo03. I'm going to let you enjoy the rest of your evening. I'm sure I still have a lot of food to stock up on. Then tomorrow being Easter Monday, yes, you definitely have a lot of catching up to do with your food still, but there'll be a repeat of the show Wednesday at 11 a.m. Let's catch you next weekend with Moshe. May God bless you. Keep safe and keep watching Urban. I'm out.